visiting with us today. We are doing things a little bit out of the normal because tonight kicks off our vacation.
Hey.
And we're going to Big Fish Bay. And you can see that a few things have started changing. So tonight you need to come back and see the rest of it. We have a lot going on. And we're just very excited. This is going to be a great week. And I'm just very excited. I'm so thankful we're doing this in church, so that you get just a little glimpse of what's happening this week. So at this time, we're all going to stand up and we're going to sing, which song is Angie?
We're going to start out with Glory to His Name.
And this song is in our church book. It's a little bit different than we're normally, when we normally sing it. It is page 544 in our church hymnal, so that you have the words. And Miss Angie will take it away.
Remember, this one goes a little faster than we're used to.
Two.
We start tonight. And we start out with supper. Mm. Supper will be ready at 5:30. Please come if you can. I believe tonight is taco night. Am I right? Yes, okay. So come on out. Who doesn't like a good taco? So we will be marching in up here, starting our service at 6:45. So if you can't make it for supper, come on out. 6:45 we'll be starting. There will be an adult class. Someone asked me, I don't think I mentioned it. So there will be an adult class. So we have classes for all ages. And everyone is welcome. Continue to invite people. It's not too late. Even if they can't make it tonight, they can come tomorrow night or Tuesday night or Wednesday night, just whenever they want. Thursday night will be our traditional ice cream night. So start dusting off them ice cream freezers. And I'm expecting some good creative recipes this year. We've had 2 years to plan. So right after church, I need to meet with all my workers, my teachers, all my stations, the food crew, everybody. We could just meet up here. It won't take but just a minute, and then we'll meet back tonight. Also, I need some men to help me move this furniture. It's very heavy, so if you don't mind some people helping me with that. And that's all I have. I'll be quiet for a little
while. Let's all turn to page 178. Taking part, even Haley behind her camera. Great job she's done for us during this.
and we certainly thank her for that. I don't leave anybody out, but that just came to my heart. I wanted to mention that. We always fall short. Remember all those on our newsletter that are prayer list? There's none others. We'll go right into our birthdays this week.
Matt, let's remember the Wanda Jones family, please.
Thank you. Wanda Jones has passed away.
And man, I got a phone call from my cousin a couple days ago. A friend of hers that she went to school with, and they've been friends. 2 years ago, she lost her husband. Last year, she lost her son, and she just lost her grandson. And she just found out she had cancer, so y'all pray for her.
Remember that thing. Certainly.
Man, I'd like to mention Michael Spur again. He's still in critical condition in the hospital with COVID. So keep praying for him.
Thank you, Scott. Birthdays today. Gina Rogers, Julie Davis.
Bagley, sorry.
Ron McCallum. Still had to change it in town. Alice Jackson today. Are you and Julie the same age?
Mm-hmm. I'm her age.
Tomorrow, Jamie Farmer. Jess Carnes. Oh, that was last week, but we missed you. Standing up there.
Yeah,
yep, standing up. Tim Henderson, we didn't catch him. Any birthdays I've missed? Anybody? All right, let's sing to these.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, God bless you. Happy birthday to you.
Thank you, many times. Any anniversaries? Anybody? Avery, we sing to you in Durham?
We did?
Okay. All right. Just wanted to check. And by the way, Scott will be signing autographs after church for the little performance.
Y'all know what Matt's talking about? I have it on my phone if y'all haven't seen the video of Scott. Just see me after church.
See you.
cold for the past few days. I was grilling some pork chops last night. I had that little speaker on my phone. I'm sure my neighbor just loves my rendition of the songs. Sitting out there singing and grilling. But I just, this song, it's just been on my heart the past few days. I've been praying, and each time, you know, these words just kept coming to me. So I sang them in the shower. I sang them to them, like I said, on my neighbors. So hopefully they enjoyed it as much as I have. If not, maybe they'll like next one. We'll see.
Darlene. with garlic on his bread.
You want to sing them? Okay, come here. She wanted to sing Jesus Loves Me.
That's pretty good.
Yeah, good job.
And every one of you for this good day that the Lord has given us. ready to rise up out of bed and come to the Lord's house. And thank God most of all for His Spirit that we're able to feel in His house this day. I want to mention just a few things before we get into the message. It's Memorial Day weekend, and tomorrow will be the day that we honor and mourn all the lives of those men and women that lost their lives serving our country in our military. And so we want to remember them. You know, freedom is not free. And some, I think it's many gave some, but some gave all. And we need to realize and know that our freedom is not free. And we need to always be very thankful and thank the Lord for the freedoms that we have. And we need to stand for our freedoms. We need to make a very strong and bold stand for the freedoms that God has given us while this country was formed, that it might be a place of freedom. And we need to make sure that we stand that those people, that would be a way that we could honor their lives as we stand for the freedom that they died for. So let's remember them. Has anybody got a name that they want to mention this morning to honor and that died serving in the military? Any names?
Rodney Davis. He flew with me, and unfortunately, he was shot down.
Any others? All right, we know there's many upon our hearts, and we're thankful today for each one of them. If you have your Bibles and want to follow along this morning, the 103rd Psalms 103. Misty, I'd like to thank you this morning for the reverence that you showed toward the pulpit and concern for God's house. We thank you, church, for that and for all the work, the church, that you do, for all the effort and work that's been put forth that we might have this service today and that we might have Vacation Bible School starting tonight and this week. It's been a lot of work, a lot of prayer, a lot of commitment and dedication being put forth, and we thank you, church, for that very much. We're looking forward to a good week in Vacation Bible School. The theme for Vacation Bible School is mercy, and I'm most thankful for the mercy of God. Mercy is a compassionate forbearance shown toward an offender, compassionate forbearance shown toward an offender. I know that through my sin I have offended God. It is an offense. A sin against God is an offense to God. And I know that I deserve something worse than what I will receive. But it's through the mercy of God, it's through His mercy that He has forgiven me, that forbearance. And that forbearance is simply patience. I'm also very thankful for the patience of God. I wish that I had more patience, and that is a place that I lack a lot of times. But God is a very patient, forbearing God. He loves us. And these qualities of God, these acts of God, go out to those that fear Him. And we're going to learn that in the 103rd Psalm here. These mercies, this patience, this loving kindness, all of this, the Bible says, goes out unto those that fear Him. We're going to start reading in the first verse, and it reads like this: Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me, bless His holy name. You know, it's our reasonable service that we bless the Lord with all that's within us, our soul and all that's within us. That is our reasonable service unto God. He deserves all that we have, not just with our soul, not just with that part within us that is saved, the Spirit of God, but with our flesh also, with every fiber of our being, that we might bless His holy name. that we might live a life and live in a way and walk in a way and talk in a way that would bless Him, that would bring Him honor and glory. That is what certainly what He deserves, and it's certainly not too much to ask of His people. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all of His benefits. Now, I don't know about your workplace, but I know that a workplace that offers a lot of benefits is something to be desired. It's part of the pay. It's something that goes along with the hours that you put in and the effort that you put in for that work that you do, and for that business or company or person that you work for. Benefits is nice. They're nice, aren't they? I drive a school bus for the benefits, not necessarily for the pay, but for the benefits that come along with that job. And that is really maybe I'm hesitant to say, and I won't say it. I started to say it is the only reason, but it's not. It's not. I have learned that God may be in it, and that He's able to use us in all that we do, that we might in some way make a difference in somebody's life. But we're thankful for the benefits. And so the psalmist here begins to tell us, let's not forget the benefits. Let's think about all the things that God has done for us and is going to do, all of the things that He has promised us that He will do, that are benefits of being a child of God, that are benefits of fearing God. So he said, forget not all His benefits. And then he begins to list those benefits. The first one is forgiveness. I'm thankful. When I was just a young boy, I began to be a sinner in the sight of God. I began to have sin upon me. And we know that the Bible says that the penalty of sin is death. My Sunday school teacher, he was teaching me this morning, he brought to light something that I never quite saw in this way. In the psalm where he was reading, or proverb where he was reading, there it spoke about the fire, punishment, the punishment that God has promised Satan and all those that follow him. It talks about, the Bible tells us about an unquenchable fire. And Russell spoke a little bit about how fire stays ignited, how it continues to burn. Now the Bible said this fire, this terrible place called hell, it's an unquenchable fire, the Bible says. It's a fire that will never go out. What causes that fire? What feeds that fire? For a fire to continue to burn, it has to be fed, and it must be fed. And listen, I saw as God spoke through Russell, and as He stirred my heart, sin, the Bible said, the penalty of sin is death. And listen, sin is what fuels that fire. And that sin, listen, to someone that dies lost, and someone that dies without the benefits of God, without the forgiveness and the patience and the mercy and the loving kindness of God, listen, their sin will never go away. It will never die. It will fuel that fire. They will be a sinner for all eternity. But when God forgave me as just a young boy, He forgave me of my sins, Billy. And those sins He washed away, the Bible said. It put out the fire. The fire, listen, that I deserve. That unquenchable fire of the penalty of sin. It was put out that day by the loving mercy and the forgiveness of God. And that fire is not fueled anymore. I'm thankful today for the forgiveness of God. That's one of His benefits that we have, those that fear Him. And then it says, who healeth all the diseases. Listen, our spiritual sickness, He heals that. He takes that sickness that we have within, that spiritual sickness, those spots, that spottedness. Listen, and He takes and He cleanses that sickness within us, and He makes us whole, the Bible says. When we're saved, we're made whole, and we're spiritually sick no more. So He gives us many great benefits. He forgives us, he heals us. And in the fourth verse it says, who redeemeth the life from destruction. We know that he is our redeemer. A redeemer is one that frees by the payment of a ransom price. Oh, listen, I deserve. I was sentenced to death there when I was born in this world. I was born into iniquity. The Bible says I was born, listen, with a nature to sin. I was born into sin. But listen, when Jesus came and saved my soul, there it was that he redeemed me. He became my redeemer. When he hung there on Calvary's cross, and his blood, listen, fell there from his body, and he died. He gave up the ghost. He died there for me without the shedding of blood. The Bible says there is no remission of sins, and the blood that was shed on Calvary's cross was a price that was paid for my sins and for yours. That's how he redeemed us. That's how he became our redeemer. Through the blood that he shed on Calvary. That was a price. His life was a price that he paid for my sins. So that's another benefit that we have through the Lord Jesus Christ today, that he is our redeemer. And then he redeems us there by a great price. Another it says, who crowneth thee with loving kindness and tender mercies. Now, I've never thought that I would ever be one that would deserve to wear a crown. We sing a song, and you can read the scriptures about how we're going to be fitted with a robe and a crown of righteousness will be placed upon our head. Listen, I know that I've never and will never within myself be worthy of a crown. When we see someone on this side with a crown, we see royalty. We think of royalty. We think of somebody that is very high up, somebody that deserves a great honor, that is worthy. Listen, today the Bible says that he's going to crown us with his loving kindness and his mercy. We're going to be crowned with the love of God. Listen, that is a benefit that we have today. We're going to wear a Roman crown. Listen, and it's going to be worthy through the blood of the Lord Jesus Christ, through his life that he lived for you and I, that we will be, listen, worthy to wear that crown that day. I can't imagine the Lord Jesus Christ himself, me bowing before him, Billy, and him taking the crown and placing it upon my head. Now, this isn't the crown like he wore, but the crown, that they, the hypocrites placed upon him. This isn't the crown that he wore there, the crown of thorns, that it was a mockery. This won't be a crown of mockery, but this will be a crown of God. This will be a crown of honor. This will be a crown of royalty. We've been made joint heirs with Jesus Christ. If you've been saved, if you fear God, if the blood has been applied to you, that you've been made part of the family of God. A royal priesthood, the Bible says, a royal family. You are his sons and daughters. You've been adopted into the family of God. And that is the most high, the most royal family that will ever exist. It's the family of God. You're going to receive a crown of tender mercies and loving kindness from God. Who satisfies some more benefits. It says, who satisfies thy mouth with good things, so that thy youth is renewed like the eagles. Listen, we are able to speak good things no matter what situation we may be in. Listen, we've got sick in our church. We've got those that are fighting, diseases and illnesses and sicknesses and the flesh and the heart. I'm going to tell you, no matter what we may face in this life, we are still able to speak good things with this mouth that God's given us. But we're still able to praise his holy name. For he has promised that he will deliver, that he will not leave us, but he'll be with us but through it all, by His strength and His goodness, we're always able to speak. And listen, church, we need to speak the words that He has given us to speak, the words of goodness and the words of kindness, and the words that we are, that we are the children of God, and we do have a Heavenly Father. He's given us that mouth to speak good things. And no matter where we may find ourselves, we're always able to find something good to say about the Lord, aren't we? The Lord executed righteousness and judgment for all that are oppressed. He made known His ways unto Moses, His action to the children of Israel. And the 8th verse, this is our theme verse for Vacation Bible School this week. The Lord is merciful and gracious, slow to anger, and plenteous in mercy. Oh, there is that mercy and that grace. Oh, that compassionate favor. Oh, that compassionate loving kindness and patience of the Lord our God. Oh, listen, He is a patient God. The Bible says His mercy endureth from generation to generation. His righteousness from children to children. Oh, today, His loving kindness today is shed on those that fear Him. He will not always chide, neither will He keep His anger forever. He's going to forgive. Oh, listen, that forgiveness again. It's a true forgiveness. It's not a forgiveness like I might have in the past. Oh, where if I'm wrong or somebody does a wrong against me, then I might say that they're forgiven, but there's still a remembrance of that in my head. And I still might ponder on that. I still might chide on that from time to time. But the God we serve is not like me. Oh, listen, He has true forgiveness. It's wiped away that He will remember. Listen to these verses, how wonderful and precious they are today. They're wiped away. And you'll find out here in just a minute how far they are from you. Listen, listen to this 10th verse. He hath not dealt with us after our sins, nor rewarded us according to our iniquities. Oh, I'm thankful that He has not given me what I deserve. But He has been merciful and compassionate, and He has given me something that He desires. For as the heaven is high above the earth, now listen, this is how much you are forgiven. If you're a child of God, if you listen, if you have believed with your heart and confessed with your mouth, the Bible said you shall be saved. For with the heart man believeth unto righteousness, Romans 10:10, and with the mouth confession is made unto salvation. If you have practiced that with a pure heart, listen, it said, for as the heaven is high above the earth, so great is His mercy toward them that fear Him. As far as the east is from the west, so far hath He removed our transgressions from us. Can anybody tell me the measurement in miles or in feet or in any type of measurement how far the east is from the west? That's a long way, isn't it? It's actually this way if we were to stand in the proper direction. Listen, as far as the east is from the west, so hath He removed our iniquities from us. That's a good God, isn't it? That's a patient, loving, merciful God. Oh, listen, we need to praise Him. We need to let our mouth speak of His goodness, for He is good. Like as the Father pitieth His children, so the Lord pitieth them that fear Him. For He knoweth our frame. He knows how we're made. Why? How? Because He made us. He knows our frame. He knows how we're made. He remembers that we are dust. He knows what we're made out of. He understands us better than we understand ourselves, for He has created us there. So He understands. As for man, his days are as grass, and as a flower of the field, so he flourisheth. Listen, our lives are so short, and God knows how short they are. Our days here upon earth are numbered, the Bible says, and a life even in its 90s is just a very, very small portion of time. It passes so quickly as a flower fadeth, so our life just passes away. And God knows and understands that. That's why He wants to bless us today, not tomorrow. That's why He's eager, listen, to share His mercy and His grace and His love and kindness for you today. That's why the Bible says today is the day of salvation. Harden not your heart. He wants to share that mercy and that love and that forgiveness with you today, not tomorrow, because He knows tomorrow may never come. How short our lives are. Oh, how good He is. He don't want to waste no time loving you. Oh, as parents, listen, we may let an hour or two slip by from time to time. Might we have not maybe care or love or spend the time we need with our children. We might let a day pass. We might let them slip out of the house without hugging them and tell them we love them. Be careful. We might let the time go by that we can't get by. Listen, you can't get it back. Oh, listen, every second is precious in the eyes of God. Oh, listen, He wants to spend every second of it with you. He wants to be there with you every step of the way. He don't want to waste a minute loving you and sharing with you and being your Heavenly Father and being everything that you need. Oh, listen, it said, for the wind passeth in and it's gone. It's gone so quickly. But the mercy of the Lord is from everlasting to everlasting upon them that fear Him. This is upon those that believe upon Him, that fear Him. That's where all of these great benefits go, to those that fear Him. And I want to encourage all you that's teaching Vacation Bible School, no matter what age, this coming week, if the Lord tarries His coming, I want to encourage you. I want to encourage you to teach. Make sure you cover that part of the Scriptures, that it's to those that fear Him, that they might understand and know that you must fear the Lord to receive His benefits. You must fear the Lord. You must reverence Him, know Him for who He is, reverence Him and acknowledge Him for who He is, to be able to receive His benefits. To such as keep His covenant, to those that remember His commandments to do them. The Lord hath prepared His throne in the heavens, and His kingdom ruleth over all. Bless the Lord, ye His angels, that excel in strength, that do His commandments, hearkening unto the voice of His word. Bless ye the Lord, all His hosts, ye ministers of His, that do His pleasure. Bless the Lord, all His works, in all places of His dominion. Bless the Lord, O my soul. The psalmist desired to bless the Lord, not just with his soul, but with all that was within him, with every thing that he did, with all that he could be, that he would do it to bless the Lord. Come with a song, if you would, this morning. That is the purpose that God has placed you here upon this earth. That is your sole purpose, that you might bless the Lord, that you might put a smile on His face with the life that you live, with the words that you say, with everything that you do, that you might bless the Lord. Let's stand and sing a verse of song. The song is open if you didn't come this morning. You stand in need and bow before God. I want you to know this morning He is a merciful God and He is a forgiving God. And if you do not fear the Lord today, listen, He wants to give you His benefits. He wants you. Before, but my parents will go on a big trip or they'll buy something, I'll say, I wish y'all would spend all my inheritance. And we laugh about it. I tell you, I hope they spend every penny before they're gone, but I'm going to tell you something. Oh, Lord. Woo! He's laid up some benefits for those in fear. Woo! We got a term plan. Oh, laid up. Oh, listen, the benefits that we're able to enjoy by being His as we go through this life. Oh, listen. Oh, listen. You can enjoy those benefits today that He has, and they're free. You don't have to put up with a bunch of screaming kids on the school bus to enjoy His benefits. Just fear Him. Just believe in Him. Just acknowledge Him for who He is.
and accept him as your Lord and Savior, and all the benefits not only will come free, but they'll come with great pay. Listen, it pays good to be a child of God. Oh, won't you receive it today? Oh, he wants to just pour it out. Oh, you go buy your lottery ticket, see where that gets you. But you accept the Lord Jesus and see where that gets you. Oh, today, a price beyond measure. Won't you come to the altar and receive the benefits of the Lord? Oh, as we say, go ahead and say, oh, won't you come this morning? Won't you come?
Page
535.
Been in church and children just right across the road.
here to ask prayer that they somehow make it here to church and find the Lord. Let's remember this. Anybody else? Okay, if not, thank you again, church. Well, let's just continue to pray. Pray for tonight in Bible school. We've forgotten anything? Got a meeting directly after church with all the workers. If you haven't saw the fish pond, there's a fish pond down there with a bunch of fish in it. We're going to have a fish fry after Bible school.
I'd like to personally thank the two that was involved. Linda Hendricks and Scott for putting that together. It's going to be a very memorable thing that kids, you know, you may not think, oh, we went fishing at Bible school. You know, they might remember, oh, but we had that lesson too about Jesus. So we never know what one little after activity, we don't know what these little seeds will grow into. So I'm so thankful for everyone that has put together. We hadn't even started and I'm just thankful because I know it's going to be a great week. So I'm just so excited. I'm overflowing this morning.
Amen. We've asked several of the younger ones what was their favorite part of Vacation Bible School. And I think Mike and Ricky won out over everything. They won out over Jesus. Yeah. It was the snow cone. Got the most votes. Not only can you get some Jesus, you can get some snow cones too at Vacation Bible School. God bless you. Anything else in any way? We love you. Let's just honor the Lord, lift up our hands and say thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.